History does not run linearly like a straight ruler starting with numbers 1 to 30 and numbers 1, primitive or ancient. The big lie throughout human history is the theory of evolution, and the child of the lie that follows is the theory of the early man. Publication to this fake must still be echoed by the nation that had to be colonized. Likewise, the records must be obscured and even removed. This is a global conspiracy that they created. Evolutionists have fancifully engineered imaginary schemes. In 1912, an amateur paleontologist named Charles Dawson claimed to have found a jawbone and skull fragments in Piltdown, England. The bone resembles an animal jawbone, but the skull teeth look like those of a human. This specimen was named Piltdown Man and was published as 500,000 years old. Then in 1953, the results of a thorough examination of the fossil showed falsehoods. The skull comes from a human who lived several thousand years ago, while the jawbone comes from an ape carcass that has just been buried a few years. The teeth were added later to make them look human-like and then stuffed with joints, after which the entire fossil was stained with potassium dichromate to make it look ancient. They include Australopithecus, the ape race that has become extinct as a race of human ancestors, even though there is a large and unrelated gap between apes and humans. As for the primitive human race, according to them, it is actually only a variation of the modern human race, but exaggerated as species different. In fact, there is no such chronological order. Many creatures that lived in the same period until now have the same form, which means no evolution. There has never been an Earth creature that has undergone an evolutionary process, changed from one creature to another. If it is true, there must be many fossil remains found in its transitional form. Early humans never existed, because the theory of evolution has never been proven. Evolution is a lie. So it will be useless. If the ancient museum that stores the fossils of our ancestors is used to perpetuate the theory of evolution, there are a million irregularities that must be corrected. Academic scientific truth which forces the theory of evolution, including the theory of early humans, to be removed from textbooks in school. An hour history recording calculates the beginning of the Saka year must be revised. There are no records of our ancestors before 78 AD. This is because we have agreed to count the beginning of the Saka year in that year, until our history is lost or eliminated before 78 AD. Van Koenigswald, he first found this fossil in the Sangiran area in 1936. According to Van, early humans in Indonesia were unlike other types of early humans in the world. The oldest human fossils in the world are 8, and 6 of them were found in the Indonesian archipelago in Sangiran S. Ragan. These are humans, not apes. Proving that the earliest human civilization on Earth existed in this land, Nusantara, Indonesia. Physical evidence, found fossils with an estimate of life in the period 150,000 BC based on carbon tests, in Sangiran, Java. Sangiran Archaeological Museum is an archaeological museum located in Kalaijan, S. Ragan Regency, Central Java. Here, traces of human fossil remains aged 2 million to 200,000 years can still be found relatively intact and better than others. Sangiran Museum is not a museum of ancient humans or a museum that propagates theory of evolution, which is clearly proven, imaginary, and not based in the conclusion of research, scientific facts. We see this fact there now. Archipelago humans do not come from the land, Yunnan, of the Mekong River. The oldest fossils found there are similar to those in Sangiran, also the oldest human fossils found in Australia. Anthropologists agree that the ancestor of humans today is Homo erectus, who lived on the island of Java. Early humans in the archipelago have spread to all corners of the earth, as evidenced by fossil findings also based on DNA genetic research and language dissemination. In the discourse to scientists about the spread of humans, the out of Africa theory is rated as weak compared to the out of Sundaland theory. This is evidence that our expansive ancestors spread throughout the earth, and our ancestors were the Sakha or Kakya, Aryan, spreading to 3/4 of the face between mainland India, before Veda was written there. The literacy of the word Arya is recorded in the opening sentence of the Kalasan inscription with the sentence Namo Bhagavatyai Arya Tara Yai. The text of the sentence written also in Nalanda Bihar, India on a stupa named Sariputra. Nalanda in India's Bihar was built on the initiative of the Sailendra dynasty's Balaputradua, and Sariputra is the son of the Indonesian archipelago. The text of the sentence written in Nalanda Bihar, India on a stupa named Sariputra. Iri Nalanda Mahaviharya Arya Bhiksusungasya. The name, Sariputra, is Putra Nusantara, a pioneer figure for the birth of one of the Indian teachings which is now labeled in Borobudur. He was born to a mother named Sari in Svarnadvipa, Indonesian archipelago formerly 568 to 484 BC. In the figure of the bas-relief of Borobudur, which is closed on panel number 43, a building is depicted in the form of a typical archipelago roof. The inscription on the edge of the frame reads, Mahatsakya. The word, Mahachakya, means, great power, or the people who have great power, Kakya, or Kaka, Sakha, Aryan. These are our ancestors in the archipelago, scattered hundreds of inscriptions with the date of Kaka, Sakha. The Sakha were the ones who conquered Raja Salivahana India in 78 AD, meaning that the Sakha had been around long before that year. Mahachakya, Kakya, Shitya, Sakha, Aryan were the ancestors of the Indonesian archipelago which advanced earlier. The greatest contribution of the Aryans to civilization was the introduction of the concept of Dharma. This is the concept of the teachings of the archipelago's ancestors, which are depicted in Borobudur, starting in Svarnadvipa until now they are perfectly preserved in Bali. His teaching, Dharmic original, was brought out of the archipelago. The bearers were the Brahmins, before the Veda was written in India, which means Brahmanism, recorded in the bas-reliefs of Borobudur with the literary text of the word, Kusala Dharmavajana. Dharma is presented as a central concept used to explain higher truth or the highest reality of the universe. Dharma is the basic philosophy that exists in the three teachings in India derived from the previous Indonesian archipelago. Namo Aryatara, we are Arya, Indonesia Arya, by Santosaba, WA +62 813 213.